Hi there, my name's Carrie and I had a request via email to do a video on how to install a sprinkler line under a sidewalk. I currently don't have any jobs where I need to get a sprinkler line under a sidewalk, but at my home I would like to get some low voltage landscape cable under a sidewalk from one planter area to another one. So this seemed like a good time to do a video on how to install a pipe under a sidewalk. And the process would be the same whether you need a sprinkler line under a sidewalk for lawn irrigation or you need a conduit under a sidewalk for electrical purposes. The method I'm going to use to get under the sidewalk is water pressure. And this is a water wand that I built 15 years ago just for the purpose of getting underneath the sidewalk. And as you can see here, it's a pretty simple setup. I have a hose end sprayer, a coupling, and a 4-foot piece of galvanized pipe. Normally this 4-foot pipe would work for most sidewalks that I need to go under, but my sidewalk is 6 feet wide, so what I've done is added a galvanized coupling, another 3/4 by 12 inch nipple, and then I've added a coupling, another 1/2 inch by 12 nipple, and the only reason I went to 1/2 inch was because I didn't have another 3/4 inch nipple. And on the end of the 1/2 inch by 12 inch nipple, I have a brass swivel fitting that will attach to the garden hose. And here's what the back end of the water wand looks like. So I have a 6-foot water wand to go under a 6-foot sidewalk. The next step is to start digging a trench so that the wand can sit in the trench to water under the sidewalk. What I will do next is dig a 6-foot long trench perpendicular to the sidewalk, and that's so that I can get the water wand below the lower lip of the sidewalk to start my watering. And another thing I like to do is get the trench away from the expansion joints that are in the sidewalk. That way there will be less likelihood that the sidewalk will crack where I'm watering under. And when I dig the trench, what I will try and do is pull the sod out in as big a piece as I can so that when I put everything back, there's not a lot of damage to where I've dug the trench. The trench that holds the water wand is now done, and as you can see, it's perpendicular to the sidewalk and it's about in the middle of the expansion joints. What I will do next is go on the other side of the sidewalk and dig a hole where I want the water wand to come out. This hole I will dig around 12 inches deep, and if things go right, this is where the pipe will come out from under the sidewalk. Now back to the other side of the sidewalk. What I want to do now is tunnel underneath the sidewalk around 1 foot, and there is 2 reasons for doing this. The first reason is that by tunneling underneath the sidewalk a little bit, it will give me some idea of what kind of material is underneath the sidewalk, whether it's rocky, whether there's a lot of tree roots. And the second reason is that if I don't tunnel under a little bit, when I take the hose and the pipe and turn the water on, if I don't have this hole pre-made, it will blow mud all over me when I turn the water on. I had to learn this the hard way. And as you can see, I'm pulling out a few bigger rocks. If there's a lot of rocks like this all the way under the sidewalk. This isn't going to work. The next step before watering under is to cut a pipe a little longer than the width of the sidewalk, and what I'm doing here is taping the ends of the pipe so that when I push the pipe through to the other side of the sidewalk, I don't fill it up with mud. Okay, moment of truth. I have the hose connected to the water wand, and the next step is to try and water under the sidewalk. When I turn the sprayer on, what I want to do is focus the spray into the tightest stream that I can get. Then I want to lay the pipe to where it will follow the bottom of the sidewalk all the way across. The starting of your hole with the pipe is the most crucial part. If you have the pipe on an angle to where it's watering down, a lot of times when it exits the other side, you have a trench that's so deep that you can't really use it. So this initial stage is the most important. You want the pipe following the bottom of the concrete all the way across. One of the things I really like about using water pressure is that you can feel as you're watering what you're hitting as you're going. If you hit a rock as you're doing this, you can feel the rock, and then you can either pull the wand back and forth to try and get past the rock, or a lot of times you can push the wand side to side to get past a rock, or you can even sort of rotate it in a circle to get past a rock. And as you can see, I'm almost 4 feet underneath the sidewalk already. The problem now is I've hit a rock, and as you can see, I'm rotating the pipe and pulling it back and forth to try and get past the rock. It's also a good idea to periodically pull the pipe back out just to make sure that it's not going to hang up on anything. So right now I'm almost through. I have my hand on the back of the water wand, and once my hand gets flush with the sidewalk, it should be coming out the other side. And I'm almost through, but I've hit another rock, so what I'm doing is pulling the pipe side to side, and I'm also rotating the pipe in a circle just to see if I can push it past this rock. Here I'm rotating the pipe again. And I can hear water spraying out the other side, so I'm really close. Almost there. Notice how I'm wiggling the pipe side to side, rotating the pipe, trying to get the pipe to wash out the last little bit. Okay, I'm through, so what I need to do now is turn off the sprayer. Then if things go right, my PVC pipe will push right through, and it's not. Hitting the rock that I had trouble with just a few minutes ago. So what I'll do is take the sprayer and try out one more time. So there's one rock that's keeping this from being a success. You can hear the end of the pipe hitting the rock, and if I can just get it past this rock, I think I'll be okay. Okay, let's try the conduit one more time. And this time it worked. This is what the pipe looks like coming out the other side. What I'll do is suck out both holes and I can start putting everything back. Now I can start putting the longer trench back, and remember earlier when I pulled out the sod in bigger chunks? Here's, you can see why I did it that way. What I'm doing is putting the dirt in the bottom of the trench, and then I'm taking the bigger chunks of sod and putting back on the top, and this way when I'm done, you won't be able to notice the damage so much. Next, I will dig a small trench that I want the landscape wiring to go in over to my other planter area. The next step is to run my low voltage wire through the conduit to the other side of the sidewalk. And if I were using this pipe as a sprinkler line, I would be connecting up fittings so that I could run water to the other side of the sidewalk. Okay, wire's in the trench, so now on this side of the sidewalk I can go ahead and put everything back. And where this is where the pipe initially went through and I dug it out with a shovel about a foot, what I'll try and do is push as much soil back underneath the sidewalk as I can and hopefully prevent any settling. And once I have everything put back on this side of the sidewalk, what I will do is take some mulch and spread it over the low spots, and then I will reseed this spot. And in about 2 weeks, you won't even be able to tell I was here. Now to the other side of the sidewalk and put everything back here. As you can see, I have my low voltage wire placed to where I can splice it in and run power to the other planter area. And once I backfill this hole, I'll be done. So that completes this video on how to run a pipe under a sidewalk using water pressure. If you would like to see more of my videos, please visit my YouTube channel, Icekeeper1.